Hi everyone, this is Dr. Radha Sharma. I'm consultant dermatologist at Arcane Skin and Hair Clinic, Noida. Today I'm going to talk about acne and acne scar. As we all know it, it's a huge topic to talk on. So I'll be only telling you today what are the basics that we need to know about acne so we are better armed to treat yourself when it comes to acne. Because acne scars are only consequences of your acne. So if you treat your scar better, there'll be less chances of you getting acne, you getting pigmentations or other acne consequences. So firstly, if I start with acne, what is acne? Which everybody calls it pimples also in normal language. So acne is, if I talk about our, on our skin, mostly like everywhere, entire body, we have pores. They are the opening, which from which there are hair follicles and a sebaceous gland, both arises. So the sebaceous gland, which is there in your below your skin or below your pores, they are the one which produces lubricant or the moisture to your skin. Any kind of blockage into this pore creates the acne. And it has variance according to the severity of blockage. How much inflammation, how much bacterial activity is there in your acne defines the severity or how bad your acne is. You'll notice some people get those tiny eruptions on the face, which are mostly not even visible. Once they feel it on the skin, they realize it that, okay, they have something, right? They are called as comedones. I'm going to share a picture with you so you'll have a better clarity on it, that what are the types of different types of acne, because it is important for you to know the types of acne are, it defines the treatment. So there'll be one picture that will show you types of acne, then we will go for causes and other things. I'm sharing screen with you. Yeah. Let me know if you all can see the screen. Please type in there. If you can see anything on the screen, which is picture, please let me know. So if you guys all can see here is actually types of acne. So this is whitehead, blackhead, papules, pustules, and your cyst. What is whitehead? As I was talking to you, when there is inflammation under your, beneath your pores starts happening, it is subtle. It is not, there's no redness, there's no pain. You will just feel slight skin raised, something that's called as whitehead. If they look white from the top, means they are covered with a layer on your skin. So they look white. Why blackheads are black? They are also a little raised above skin, but they're open. That's the reason they're called as closed comedones also, respectively, and open comedones as well. So when we call it open comedones, means blackheads, means they're exposed to the environment. So due to a process of oxygenation, they turn black. So that's why they're called as black comedones. And there's the white comedones, which because they're covered with your skin layer at the top. So they look white in color. And then there is papules. So whenever we talk about skin, there is hair follicle surrounding to it is a sebaceous gland. So any inflammation which increases beyond this comedones can cause papules. Papules are the raised, tiny red color lesions on your skin, which might be mildly painful, but not extremely. But yes, they need to be addressed because they need proper treatment. They might leave scars or they might not leave, because if they are being treated properly with proper treatment, they might not leave scars as well. Then comes to your pustule. Pustules are the one, if you can see this another picture, here, they are the ones which have slight pus-filled lesions, which look pretty much infected, because acne also has a major role of bacterial infection. The bacteria call it Propionibacterium acne. Also, we call it C. acne. So one of the major cause of acne is also a bacterial infection. So it falls to our topical antibiotics or oral antibiotics in this treatment category when we're talking about patting. So this is your pustule. You can see this is your follicle. Here, this is rising, inflammation is increasing. The redness is all the inflammation, all the swelling that I was talking about. So it is not like pus at the top, it is saying slightly you see white pus. And what people generally do it, most of us, please don't do it. They try to pop that out. They try to squeeze the inbuilt pus into it. And that is the one which leaves scars and pigmentation, which we call as post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, very, very difficult to treat. So I tell all my patients not to pop your acne or pinch it, because that will gonna trouble in the course of treatment to you and us. It takes longer and longer time, almost double the time in the treatment process. So this is your pustule. Now, papules I've already explained. Now, very difficult to treat is cysts or nodules. You have seen many people having huge, big acnes on their faces. What they call is, they call it cyst. The problem with that is they are so much deep below your skin, as you can see this picture. That's why the cyst or nodules are formed. So they are very difficult to treat. High chances, or mostly they leave scar. Required aggressive approach so that they do not, or they go off early. So it's very important to visit your dermatologist to start early treatment, because the early you start acne treatment, the lesser the chances of pigmentation or scar. Thirdly, so these are the actual how it looks like in morphology and looks. Earlier, I have shown you the inside, what actually goes wrong. This is how it looks like from the top. This is tiny, tiny comedones, as you can see. They are here. All of them are whiteheads. Here, you can see some black spots. This they are called as blackheads. Mostly people have it on their noses and all. So they try to scrub it out very diligently, but don't do that more often, because excessive scrubbing can also give rise to acne and can do the friction, which we call, can give rise to more and more of acne there. This is the picture of papules, tiny red lesions you can see on the top of your skin. These all are called as papular acnes. These are tiny cysts. This is how your acne looks like when it's cystic. Again, needs a dermatological addressment. This is nodules. As you can see, they look very superficially. They're no opening, nothing, because they're nodular. They'll be more deeper below your skin than outside. You'll palpate, you'll try to touch them, you'll try to feel them, you'll feel that they are deeper inside your skin. So they are the one have the highest chances of leaving scar, or the deep scar, which looks literally pretty bad on the face. This is pustule. You can see this all pus-filled lesion with a lot of inflammation around it. So this is how the pustule look like. Every one of it required a different line of treatment, different approach. So let's go to the most common thing when we talk about acne is, I'll be taking questions in the end. I'm getting a lot of queries. So can we take questions? When I'm finished with acne part, when I'm done with acne talk, then I'll take the questions over acne. And when I'm talking about scar, then I'll take the questions on acne scarring also. Hi, Kamalpreet. Hi, Amisha. All of you, I have noted your questions. I'll address them. Hi, Ranveer. I'll address them in the end of my talk. Yeah? Thank you. Yes. We'll talk about PCOD here only in this conversation. Then I'm going to talk about causes of acne. So I'm coming to that. So very important is when you are treating your acne is what is caused, what is the underlying etiology with your acne. So it's important to treat the cause of acne for the fact not to let them come back. If you do not treat the cause, you will keep getting your acne or back and back. So first of all, whenever you have acne, consult a dermatologist. Do not go to over the counter and buy any ointments and start applying it. Because sometimes whenever you go OTC, you always find steroids. So no matter which concern you go to a chemist shop or any other medical stores outside or nearby, your friends told you, they always give you a steroid or they always give you a combinational cream, which might definitely increase the efforts which gonna come in treatment part. More treatment required, number of tablets or the topical creams I'm talking about, more duration will be required. The longer the duration will go, because we might have to treat your skin first, but after the side effects of the tubes or the topical steroids you have applied, then I can only treat acne. So it is like 15 to 20 days you have to give your skin to heal. Then I can start some of the acne treatments, because all medication which works on acne, they are a little harsh at times. So I'll be very restricted to treat, or any dermatologist so is when if you have applied anything over the counter. So let's talk about, okay, Anil, Rani, I'll be taking your questions. Yes. Pranjal, hi, I'll be taking your questions right after my acne talk. So yes, let's come to causes of acne. What causes acne? Starting from, as I've already spoken, bacterial infection. There is a bacteria which is there in your skin, which is P. acne, propionibacterium. Any kind of infection, any kind of blockage can produce this inflammation or can cause bacterial infection, most common cause. Second is hormonal, which many people have already written to me to talk about. I am going to talk, or it's itself a huge topic when we talk about PCOS. That's a polycystic ovarian syndrome. It is a multifactorial causes itself comes into. There are many hormones. So what happens is we need to look whenever we're getting acne. Am I getting it right before my menstrual cycle? Am I getting it 7 days before, or is there any delay? So we need to do a thorough analysis of your hormone or your menstrual cycle or how irregular is your period. So that matters in cases of PCOS. PCOS is a lifestyle problem. So another most common cause involved or associated with it is your diet or your lifestyle, which comprises of stress also. So another two more causes which I've included in PCOS only is stress and your lifestyle. So when we talk about stress, what it does is definitely when we're stressed about something, our hormones fluctuate. Whenever there is any fluctuation of our hormones, PCOS kind of things start happening with you. With diet, when I talk about high glycemic index diet, very controversial to talk about. People say that diet does not play any role. Some people say it does. So it depends, but high glycemic food definitely plays a huge role in cases of acne. When I talk about PCOS, be very careful when you're visiting your doctor, because it has a lot of treatment involved to it. Hormonal therapies, there are a lot of tablets to be given in cases of PCOS. So firstly, get yourself examined, thorough examination. Get yourself diagnosed. What is my cause? Why am I getting acne? Sometimes you might be doing a lot of workouts. You might be getting proteins, high-rich diet. They also causes opening or enlargement of these glands. So first, very, very important to find out cause of your acne. Then if I say it's your treatment part, but let me see some of the questions, because I have a lot of questions to answer. So when it comes to treatment, as I have already spoken earlier, that find out the cause first. Second, which stage of acne you are at, which grade of acne you are. If they're very small, tiny, few numbers, they can be very well treated with topical treatments or some cream or the gels, which comprises your antibiotics, your retinoids, your benzoyl peroxide. Excellent treatment, benzoyl peroxide for acne, but only if you know that what you are trying to treat. I'll give it to the more infected acne than anything. If you have comedones, the treatment changes. I would prefer retinoids, topical retinoids in that case. So it's important to know that what type of acne you have, and that decides the treatment line mostly. So get yourself thoroughly examined on the treatment line. oral treatment, when I talk about, I would say the most important problem nowadays we suffer as a dermatologist is that poor compliance. When I try to treat acne, if I've given a medication for 15 days, I would want you to come back after 15 days or you, whosoever you go and get yourself checked for your acne, please go for your follow-up. It is important. Acne does not go in a week, 10 days or 15 days of time. You need a constant follow-up along with the treatment of somewhere around 2 months or 3 months. Depends what treatment you are taking. Are you on just on the topical? Are you on oral medications or somewhere like other modalities or other things which you call it chemical peels or laser treatments? Very beautiful treatment if I could talk about for acne chemical peels. So mostly what I do is I try to combine with my, so then my time duration shrinks down when I'm talking about treatment. So I'll put some of the chemical peels along with some of the topicals or the oral treatments. So most of the time, these kind of procedures do take care of your pigmentations, your active acne, your oil secretions, and your scar forming tendencies. So combining your medicated treatment along with your peels and other stuff definitely reduces the time required for the treatment and a better outcome of your acne and the result. Okay, so let me take some of the questions because there are a lot of it. So, okay. Okay, so hi Roshni. Roshni saying, is there a proper way to cleanse my face so I don't get acne? Yes, that is the prevention is the first line to cure something. If you take a good care of your skin, because there's a myth that people say that only oily skin or combinational skin people do get acne. Yes, the chances of you getting acne if you have oily skin or combinational skin are definitely higher. But yes, people with drier skin also do get acne. So depending upon how you take care of your face, that also matters. So cleansing, yes. If you have a acne-prone skin or a oily skin or a combinational skin, please use a cleanser based on glycolic acid and salicylic acid. They kind of control your acne or oil secretions on a daily basis. It's important to wash your face twice daily, once in the morning, once at night. Once you come back home, make sure you take off all your makeup, all your dirt that you have carried. If you don't do so, then there's a possibility of your pores to get clogged, and along with the dirt, along with infection that you've carried entire day by touching your face multiple times and other things are pretty much higher. So you sleep on with makeup on and you'll get up with one or two acnes in the morning. So it's important to clean your face thoroughly. Make sure you take a good amount of cleanser, clean it properly, at least for a few seconds. So all the areas is cleaned properly and wash it off with the water. Put a good acne control moisturizer, the moisturizer which is most likely to be on gel base. Use those moisturizers. So every skin needs moisturizer, irrespective of having a drier, oily or acne or sensitive. So moisturizer, yes, you will have to apply. Some people come and ask me that I have oily skin. Whenever I apply some moisturizer, I feel very greasy. Yes, because you are using the wrong kind of moisturizer. Stick to gel-based moisturizers or a little bit less moisture or less in texture, lighter side of the moisturizer, I'm saying. So cleaning your face is very important, as I told you. How you can do it with certain type of moisturizer, but do change your cleansing agent or do change your face washes when the weather changes. You might not need salicylic or glycolic based cleanser in a weather like this where it's already so dry, because salicylic and glycolic have a tendency to dry out your skin. So make sure either you're reducing the frequency of it, you're just using it once in a day rather than twice in a day, or you're moisturizing yourself well, or you're switching off to a lighter side of the cleanser. So depending your skin type, you should always choose your moisturizer. Hope I have answered your queries. If Amisha, if anything at all is there, you can inbox me. I will be happy to answer. Next question is Nuvit. Is Nuvit is good for skin? Yeah, it's vitamin D and zinc. Definitely, they're good. There are a lot of studies shows that vitamin D deficient or zinc helps in healing. That's the work and the antioxidant also. So yes, it does help. Vitamin C and zinc, but always, always consult a dermatologist when you're starting it. Not everyone needs it. So vitamin C, yes, you can, because it works an antioxidant. So anybody can use it. But when you're starting with zinc, do consult a dermatologist. Do not take it for a longer duration than required. So whenever you're on any kind of oral medication, give yourself a break to it for using it minimum of 4 to 6 months. Always under a dermatological opinion or consultation. I have Amisha. Okay. Can aloe vera be used to cure acne in teenagers? See, that's another very good topic to talk on, acne in teenagers. See, nowadays we cannot define acne as age-related concern. Everybody gets it, acne. I get patients when they say that I never had acne in my teenagers. Now I'm getting it. So yes, due to lifestyle modifications, anybody can, at any age, can get acne. Aloe vera has a tendency to improve your skin texture or has a good antioxidant or anti-inflammatory property. They will not treat your acne. You need medication for that. Once acne has been treated, you can use it as a moisturizer for your skin, but never take it or to clean your skin. And then if you take care of it, acne might not come back, but aloe vera does not treat it. So on nothing to do with that, specifically with the teenager, anybody, any one of us can use aloe vera at any age, because that's a beautiful moisturizing agent, along with having a lot of skin textural improvement property. What lifestyle changes should I make to combat acne? Okay, so then Ranveer, right? Yeah. So Ranveer, when we talk about lifestyle changes, it includes managing your stress, managing your diet, eating a lot of fried foods, not really much, but yes, high glycemic, eating a lot of fried foods, stress. These are the major factors that involves in your taking care of your good face, maintaining a hygiene. Maintaining hygiene means after washing your face, you make sure you change your pillow almost every day when you're sleeping. Because what happens, you apply the moisturizer this night and then you sleep on this pillow. That pillow itself has a lot of moisture of your previous night. So next day, if you go back and sleep there, you will probably get acne, or you'll probably get the moisture which has been, or the dirt which has been carried by a pillow. So it is very, very important to at least use a fresh pillow every time you're going off to sleep. That's how you can maintain your hygiene of your face. Lifestyle, sleep properly, that also matters. To control your stress, avoid sugar. These are like the food which are high glycemic index food. So eat fruits which are high rich in antioxidants and all. Kamalpreet, hi. Hormonal acne, PCOD. PCOD, okay, so PCOD and PCOS both are same. This earlier we used to call it PCOD, now people are called as PCOS. So polycystic ovarian syndrome, it's a hormonal, it's a lifestyle problem. Change your lifestyle, do something that relaxes your hormones. So what happens is whenever we are taking any stress, or we are getting hormones, right? We are getting acne right before our periods. Most of the time we get it 7 to 10 days before our periods. So that means you need to control your bad hormones, which goes up when your periods are about to come. So by doing certain relaxing exercises, workouts, weight reductions, meditations, these kind of activities do control your daily stress. So it is very important, please check for your weight. Please look for the history in your family that either of your parents, your mother, yes, genetics also plays a role in acne. So please check that either your mother or your father had acne problem in their teenage, then most likely you will have issues throughout your life. But yes, you can definitely get a treat. But if you have a genetic history, you need extra care of your face all your life. So PCOS treatment is only and only treatment of lifestyle modifications. I do not prefer to personally give popping pills for PCOS because it's not a disease as such. It's a lifestyle problem. So the more you take care of yourself, the more you take care of what you eat, how you stay, how better you work out. These things, if you do it, they will take care of your PCOS condition. Do get yourself checked, definitely diagnose that you have PCOS or not. There's blood investigations along with ultrasound. So do get it done before you start anything related to PCOS. Acne on jawline, PCOD hair solution. Okay. So I have already explained Kamalpreet about PCOS. As you all know it, jawline acne is majorly due to hormonal only. So please do get yourself checked, whether investigate yourself, whether you do actually have any hormonal imbalance or just your stress, which is fluctuating your hormones. So the treatment remains same. Because of PCOS, not just the acne, you get other issues like unwanted facial hair and all also. So PCOS is a very complex thing to diagnose. So it's just not the acne, people get it. So make sure you check out other stuff also related to PCOS. What is mask acne? Which is the most common? What is most common nowadays due to use of mask? And what remedies you suggest to prevent the same? Okay. So as the term says, mask acne is the acne you get in the area you wear your mask. So most of the time nowadays, what people are having acne is because occlusion. All the time, you're occluding yourself. The kind when you talk, under the mask, you are generating a good heat in there, and there's a force. Then there's a inbuilt moisture is happening due to occlusion of that mask. This is called as mask acne, having acne under your mask area. Treatment, see, depends how severe are they. If you have just started getting it, you start using a good face wash, start using a good cleanser based on your salicylic acid and glycolic acid, as I already told you before. Second is moisturize your face. So whenever you wash it, right before you wear your mask, please moisturize this area. With depending upon your skin type, use your moisturizer. Then wear your mask and try not to wear it if it's not required. That would I say, whenever you go out, don't wear it unnecessarily. Then once you take that mask off, again, wash your face right after taking it off and then moisturize your face. Moisturizer is very, very important in cases of mask acne. If at all you're not able to control it, you might have to start certain medications, topical, depending on the condition, topical or oral, because mask acne is something that you can't control. You'll have to like do certain do's and don'ts to for them not to come. Is coconut oil good for acne scars? Yes, any kind of moisturizing is good for acne scars, Anil. See what happens, how the acne scars happen. I think I should talk a bit about acne scars also quickly so that I'll take rest of the questions after that. So we were on the acne. Acne scars is actually the consequences of your acne. So what happens is when your skin is normal, our collagen is most likely parallel arranged to each other. This, anything happens here, any inflammation, any injury, scars, trauma, which I called acne also, a trauma or an injury to the skin. After that, there's a proper inflammation process happen. When this inflammation is gone down so deep in cases of mostly nodular acne or the cystic acne, this tissue below your skin starts rearranging it, right? It has occluded this way, or it can be, the arrangement can be of any, because there's healing. So after healing, this process become like this. So from the top, this pits like things look like scar. Acne scar, if you start using coconut oil, but see, the problem here is coconut oil is a moisturizer. Again, it's a heavy moisturizing content. So if you use it for your face and acne prone skin, I would not advise you to do that. Other areas, if you have acne, you can use it for just to prevent scar or any kind of scar if you have it, no matter what the cause is, injury or traumatic scar. Yes, it works really well in cases of coconut oil. In cases of stretch marks also, it works very well. So if it's like one or two scar, you can, does taking stress causes acne? Yes, it does, definitely. So depending upon the type of scars, we decide the treatment for scars. We have many type of scars, starting from ice prick to rolling to box scars. Depending, like, let's say if I have ice prick, my treatment line changes. If I box, I'm rolling, my treatment changes. But very, very rarely anything topical works on acne. You will always have to release the band which has been formed below your skin after acne. So these bands need to be broken down by any modalities like lasers or microneedling or derma roller. So what are these things are when we talk about acne scar treatment? So first thing called is your derma roller, which is handheld devices with tiny pins in the end. So what we do is, after putting a numbing cream like on your face, we try to break those bands with those needles on your face. When those bands are broken down, they start building a new collagen. And when the new collagen is forming, they make a scar look much smoother or better. Don't expect your scar to go completely and makes it look smoother, like nothing happened over that area. No, that's not gonna happen. We can always make your scars look better and smoother. Second treatment I was talking about is MNRF, that is microneedling radio frequency. Beautiful treatment. Additional advantage is it's a machine-based treatment. It has, again, microneedling. It's a tip that comes with tiny 25 microprints. We can decide the depth, intensity, radio frequency we want to deliver. What radio frequency does is it builds more collagen. So needling is breaking down those stopped bands. And then on top of that, we are delivering the RF along with needling. So it kind of gives a good skin texture along with the tighten the skin also. RF always works for the skin tightening. So additional advantage in this, treating your scars and your open pores. So RF shrinks your pores in that case. Lastly, lasers. There are plenty of lasers to CO2 and all when we talk about laser, erbium glass lasers and all. So depends which scar, which type of scar I am treating. I prefer my treatment. It can be TC also at times we use this. So it's very important to get yourself diagnosed in cases of scar as well. Let me take some of the questions. But get yourself treated as early as possible when it comes to acne. That's how you can prevent scar happening. If you treat yourself well early and right for your acne, you might not need any scar treatment in the future. Let me take two or three questions now. Just taking stress, we're done with Sean. Is vitamin C good for removing acne? Okay. No, the vitamin C does not remove your acne. Does light therapy improve the quality of life for people with acne? See, yes, it does. Blue light works very well for acne, but depends where you're taking it. Be very, very careful with all the machines treatment that you get it. Any kind of a lasers and all and everything. It's important to check with your machine whether they are USFDA approved or not. But yes, they do help. Because blue light has anti-inflammatory properties. So what they do is they kill the bacteria also along with the anti-inflammatory activity. It works very well. Hi, Rani. Can moisturizers cause acne? Yes, I've already spoken about it. Yes, it can, but depending upon your type of moisturizer, if you're using a right moisturizer according to your skin type, you will not get acne. Dharmesh, hi. Can affect hair oil to acne? Oh, yeah. Very, very good question. Yes, hair oil. Oh, you've seen, and that's a condition caller. You've seen many will get acne around this hairline. Or some like acne pomade that they call it, or somebody who like, I'm keeping my hair like this. So when you keep your hair like this, or you keep it on the forehead, you're constantly constantly touching your face with the product that you applied in, on your hair, whether it's the oil or serum, if at all it's a dandruff. So these three things, yes, definitely can cause acne. So you have to be very careful when you're getting acne around your forehead lines or on the sides that you keep your hair on. So be careful with the combination of oily skin, the product you're applying. If you at all you want to do oiling on your hair, and since winters are here, because hair gets drier, so everybody likes to do oiling and all. So do it, but don't keep it for a longer duration. Do not sleep with oil on your hair if you have acne-prone skin at all. So yes, keep your oil for half an hour so that you do not get acne due to hair oil. Because it drips down, right? The oil and from your hair follicles. Hi, Sapna. Okay. Does lack of sleep causes acne? Yes. When you're not sleeping properly, you're definitely stressed about something. That, again, is a very, very common cause of acne. So please take a good sleep. Control your stress. Kavya. Hi, Kavya. Can aloe vera be used to cure acne in teenagers? I've already answered this question earlier. Raja, hi. Ma'am, which moisturizer should be used in oily skin? See, I've already answered this question. For oily skin, definitely everybody needs moisturizer, but make sure your moisturizer is not greasy enough or it's a gel-based moisturizer. Sometimes now the market is coming up with the silicone-based moisturizer also. So it depends that what kind of you have. Or just the oily skin or you have a combinational skin. Never, okay, so when the weather changes, moisturizer may, I would talk one thing which is very important. Whenever the weather changes, you might feel that my earlier moisturizer is not working well. I still feel drier because of the winter dryness or something. Please increase the quantity of your moisturizer rather than switching back or changing your moisturizer, because your skin, that particular moisturizer has suited your skin. So there's no point of changing it. You anyway need good moisture. So increase your quantity rather than changing a moisturizer type that I don't prefer with acne-prone skin or oily or combinational skin to do a lot of changes. Then I have, I'll have to take questions only because we are running out of time. So let me take questions, some more questions quickly. Please inbox me or write down to me. I will leave my page information here in the chat box when I'm done with my talk. So any one of you can connect me anytime later on. Okay, Raja, ma'am, which moisturizers? We done with that. Anil, what triggers acne? Okay, so definitely you need to treat your cause first. Any kind of cause which is there can trigger your acne if you're not treating it. That's mostly the triggering factor. Apart from that, overwashing your face. If you are, like some people say that I have oily skin or acne prone skin, I wash my face like 4-5 times in a day. No, not required. You only need to wash your face twice daily. You washing your face aggressively 4-5 times causes a lot of friction. Any kind of friction gives rise to acne, because constant rubbing to any infection, infection or inflammation on the skin definitely can aggravate your existing acne and can give rise to new acne as well. So avoid that. As I told you about changing your pillows, using your diet, your stress management, your weight, these all are the triggering factors only. Yeah. We are not able to see the pictures. Does sweat causes acne? Yes, I'll explain it here. Why sweat is. So when I was explaining this diagram, is right close to this hair follicle, there is a sebaceous gland and there is a sweat gland also. So yes, if you sweat too much, maybe not all the time. So apart from these triggering factors, I've already covered everything. Yes, certain medications do cause acne too. So please be careful whenever you're getting treatment for anything, something which involves steroid-based and all, please keep a watch on your acne. There's a possibility that you can get acne on face. Apart from face, you can get acne on other body parts also, most likely on the upper back and shoulders. Then they call as acne form eruptions. So be careful with certain medications if you are on. If you're getting acne right after 10 or 15 days after starting certain medications, please keep a track of to it. Then there's a question. Hi, Vedi. Do the severity of skin problem affected by number of bacteria on skin surface? Okay. No, not really, because it's just not the bacteria that involves. It's collaboration with many other factors that involved in acne. So number of bacteria, definitely you cannot decide, because nobody knows. It's a pore, yes, definitely. But not at all number of bacteria, and you cannot. There's only one bacteria which involves or which plays a role in cases of acne. It's, I already told, Propionibacterium acne. So number, nobody can define. Okay, then there is lovely. Hi. Do breakouts just mean you don't wash your face enough? I have already explained about it right now that too much washing is also not good. So yes, you need to wash your face, but only once or max twice, no more than that. Ranjit, which one good sunscreen has? Okay, can you just send your question again? Or which one is a good sunscreen, I believe you're trying to ask. So yes, everybody needs sunscreen. Again, it's a very, very important anti-aging agent. Along with that, when we try to treat our patient with certain procedures, we do need sunscreen. On top of that, when our acne are healing, there's a tendency sometimes the acne heal ho raha hota, so it leaves kind of a black spot. There's a black mark, which we call pigmentation. So during those times, if you go out in the sun without protecting you with sunscreen, there's a possibility of higher chances of PIH will be there. The pigmentation might be more darker and more lesions will get pigmentation, or more acne will get pigmentation if you do not use sunscreen, if you have acne. So use your sunscreen according to your skin type. That's again very important. We have so many sunscreen in the market. Please consult a dermatologist or write it down to me. According to your skin type, I can decide and give it to you. But do not just pick one and start using it. If it's not according to your skin type, you are protecting yourself from sun, but it might in return give you some acne too. So the question is, sunscreen we are done with. Hi Atul, is it necessary to use sunscreen long term? Yes. Always, starting from as early as you can. I start my patients on somewhere around 16 years, or maybe if they're into sports, maybe pretty early to as long as you can, because nobody wants to age. It's excellent anti-aging cream or agent, sunscreen is. Then we have Atulvida. Sanjay, hi. Is acne problem also due to hormonal imbalance? We have answered that as well. Yes, it does. PCOS patients should go to gynecologist or a dermatologist. Okay, so depending, I personally do not prefer either. I do not treat my patients if they are having PCOD. It's a hormonal problem. So we have another specialty called endocrinologist. So consult an endocrinologist if your acne are not going, if you have diagnosed with PCOS, but please first get yourself diagnosed whether you have it or not and consult an endocrinologist. Which of the hormone triggers acne in adolescents? Plenty of it, starting from prolactin to testosterone to LH, FSH, insulin. You need to get your ultrasound done to check your ovaries volume and size. So there's not just one hormone. It's when we talk about PCOS, it's a syndromic approach. It's a syndrome. So there will be plenty of hormones involving and giving this issue, PCOS. So it can be any of the hormone that is giving rise to. So you have to go through entire screening of hormonal panel to get it. Hi, Ashok. Ma'am, please suggest treatment for acne scar. I have already discussed this. Another thing very important I would want to say over acne scars is the earlier you treat your scar, the better it is, because the longer you delay with it, there'll be stiffness will occur. So the more the stiff tissues are, the harder to treat them. So as soon as you treat your acne problem, start your scar treatment, because you'll get much, much better result than if you start thinking of doing it after years and all. So the older the scar, the worse or the poor the results are. Let me quickly take some more questions because we don't have much time. Acne scar, does frequent change in soap causes acne? I do not advise soap. I'm sorry. Yes, cleanser, face wash, because soap has a lot of drying agents, so that unnecessarily harm your face. So I do not advise soap for face. Dinesh, frequent change, definitely you should not change very frequently whatever you're using, even if it's a cleanser, even if it's a soap. Hi, Zilla, should I take any vitamin supplement to beat acne? Yes, you can. You can take vitamin D, you can take vitamin B12, you can take zinc, but depending, apart from this, you might need other treatment also. So if it's severe form of acne, if you're constantly getting it, please try to rule out the cause of it. Otherwise, there's no point of popping supplements if you have not treated the cause of it. They will just, as rightly said, they will just supplement it. They will not treat your acne. Hi, Amisha. Some cosmetics and skin products can make acne worse. Okay, maybe you're trying to say worse. What kind of cosmetics is least likely to do so? Okay, so if you have acne-prone skin, please do not use cosmetics which are oil-based. So there is a this different trend has set up in the market. They've come up with a oil control cosmetics and all. So please go for those kind of cosmetics. And please do always do a patch test with any kind of cosmetics you try on your face. Kamalpreet, madam. Okay, myonisotol helps with acne. Yes, it does help in acne, only if it's hormonal. Only if you get your acne 7 to 10 days before your periods, yes, it does help. But definitely it needs to be taken longer. You need to take it twice daily, at least in the initial days. And to be taken at least for pretty much 4 to 6 months. Then we have Dhananjay. Hi. Is there a need to cover face in sunlight to get protection against acne? No. But still use your sunscreen to protect it, because it is not needed. Just for your acne, it does not give you pigmentation. For that reason, you can protect it from sunlight by covering it with a sunscreen. Swati, I have a lot of acne scars. Can you suggest me to solve this? Swati, I would love to see a picture of your scar, because as I already mentioned, I need to know your scar type. So you can share your pictures with me, then I'll let you know that what treatment will go for your type of scars. But there's no topical that works very well on acne scars. Then we have Zilla. Does Vaseline remove acne scar? No, it does not remove. It might just make it a little better, because Vaseline is also a moisturizing agent. So any scar which is there does require moisturizer. That's how you can make your scar look smoother or better. So as coconut oil, as we have discussed earlier. Jennifer, hi. Does drinking water help acne? No. Because reason, drinking water keeps your body hydrated, but they'll not help in acne. Otherwise, overall, it's good to have it. But it will not be doing anything, or it will not treat your acne. So yes, keeping your body hydrated is good to have a good, healthy skin, but just not for acne for sure. Pranjal, do you have Okay. See, yes, it does, because we also write medication that you're going to go and buy from a medical store only, but take it from an authentic dermatologist. Do not go and just pick up anything from the counter. Mostly they give steroid. Please read whenever you buy anything from a medical store. If at all it has steroid, do not use it, because it makes your skin go more and more and more sensitive. It will subside your acne for pretty much for 5 to 7 days or 10 days, and then you'll get it back much higher in number and much worse in severity. So I never prefer, unless you have authentic dermatologist prescription to go and buy it. What diet should I follow for removing acne problems? Okay. High glycemic index diet. Sometimes people do have, so there's a hormones also, which is prolactins and all and everything involved. So you should definitely avoid high glycemic index diet. But any kind of oily and fried food you should. Does diet make acne worse? Yes, definitely it does. A lot of sugar intake, you should avoid. Kamal, please. Medama can use on cystic acne scars? Not really, because scar, it's a moisturizer. I would prefer, if it's a scar, you use any moisturizer. If at all, you cannot go to any dermatologist and get other treatments, because they will not do anything. I already explained this pathology of your fibers being clogged below your skin. So the fibers need to be opened. They need to be released. So the scar can lift up. They can bring back to normal. If I am putting anything from the top, it can only make it a little bit better, but the results you will not like. Hi, Aman. Can you please suggest good acne moisturizer? We've already spoken about it. It can be used for daily. Yes, you should use moisturizer on a daily basis, because acne skin do need moisturizers as well. Pallavi, which peel would be better in cases of acne? Okay, so when we talk about chemical peels or peels for acne, there's a beautiful peels available. Either they can be used alone or they can be used in combinations. When I talk about alone, you can use salicylic acid, but depending upon your skin severity, we decide which percentage of salicylic would go for you. Then we have glycolic acid, then we have mandelic acid, citric acids and all. So they all work excellent, but I prefer salicylic acid or mostly glycolic acid for that reason. There are other peels also for more aggressive approach, but that needs high supervision. Okay, there's a active acne, which peel? I'm done with that. Is there anything I can do to clear up my post acne marks faster? So Sandesh, definitely, but we need to understand there are marks or there are scars. Some people do mistaken with their pigmentation, which is black color residual. Once acne heals, they leave a black color spot or a mark. That's your pigmentation. That's not your mark. Then there is a scar. Scar is a discontinuity in your skin. There is a depression. There is a proper pit on your skin. That's called a scar. So please specify, you are asking for marks or pigmentation, or you are asking for scar. But definitely, either of it can be treated. Pigmentation, don't pop and pinch your acne. That's how you can prevent the pigmentation to happen. Hi Krishna, is surgery necessary to remove acne scar? Not really, because surgery will also give you another mark, another scar. So go for procedures like microneedling, derma rollers, this thing. TCA spot, sometimes people does it depending upon your skin type. We have derma pens also, which has small tiny needles that works very well on the. It's the pathology is to building more collagen and bringing it, facing too much acne kindly. Okay. Again, Ramratan, which moisturizer is good for acne skin? I have already spoken about it, which moisturizer. Vinay Kumar, doctor, I'm facing too much acne. Kindly suggest any diet or food. Doctor, it's winter time. On a daily basis, I use Vaseline moisturizer. I think because of this moisturizer, I'm facing acne. Okay, kindly acne friendly. So, hi Vinay. Please do not use Vaseline. That's a very strong, it's a petrolatum jelly. It contains a strong moisturizer component. So do not use Vaseline. You can use or stick to any good gel-based moisturizer for acne. They are good. They control your acne. They control this high chances of getting acne due to moisturizer. Because what happens is the thick moisturizer block your pores. So you have to use a light gel-based moisturizer in that case. You can write it down. I'll let you know. Hi, Preeti. Can acne scar heal naturally? It will not heal, but yeah, it will be better. Because see, whenever any acne happens, or any scar happens, your skin's own immunity, own healing process involved to it. So definitely, scar will get better with time, but there's a certain time after 3 or 4 weeks of healing, it won't improve much. So you should only wait for months, like 1 or 2 months after your acne has healed. Whatever the potential your skin has to heal your scar, it will do that in this period of time, and then you can start any treatment that you wish for it. Okay. So hope I have not missed anybody's question. If at all, please let me know. I'll just go through once with the list of questions. So if it's anything I've missed, please write it down to me, because I just have another minute with. Only if these questions. Yeah. So I think I have spoken everything related to the acne and acne scar. But very, very important thing, as I told you and I kept telling in my entire talk, please get yourself checked with a good dermatologist. It is important to know the cause, what is causing your acne, to rule out which treatment, then only you can rule out which treatment is good for you. The earlier you start your treatment, the better it is, because acne also causes a lot of psychosocial impact on many of my patients. So when the acne start happening, they get a lot of cystic acne also. So they are not comfortable going out, and this confidence goes down. So for you, it is important you start treating acne as early as possible, get them right diagnosis, rule out the cause of your acne. Certain do's and don'ts that I have told you, have to follow it every time. So maintain a good hygiene, use a good product, right, and a good product for you. So I think we are done with today's session. I really enjoyed answering your questions. If at all anything is there, please write down to me. I will be happy to answer. I am leaving my email address along with my page, Instagram and Facebook. All of you can write down to me there. Thank you so much. Yeah.